Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 6 in the module PERT CPM. The topic for today's discussion is CPM, constructing CPM network and calculating the critical path in the CPM computation. The learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the students will be able to find critical path of the CPM network. In the earlier lectures, 5 lectures, we discussed the PERT network and calculated the critical path of the PERT network. So this lecture and the next lecture will be on the CPM network. Critical path method. So the various terminologies used in the critical path method CPM are: the earliest start time. The earliest start time of an activity is the earliest occurrence time of the event from which the activity begins. The earliest start time of the ith event is given by ESI equal to TEI. So TEI is the earliest occurrence time, earliest expected time of the event I. So which we calculated earlier. So we calculate TEI and which is equal to ESI, the earliest start time of the ith event. The latest completion time. So it is the latest occurrence time of an event at which the activity terminates. The latest completion time of the jth event is given by LCJ. Latest completion time of the jth event is equal to TLJ. So TLJ we have calculated earlier using the backward pass computation. So we have to calculate TLJ, which is equal to LCJ. And the latest start time of the activity, LSIJ equal to LCJ minus TEIJ. So TEIJ is the time of the activity IJ. LCJ is the latest completion time of the event. And earliest completion time ECIJ equal to ESI plus TEIJ. ESI is the earliest start time of the ith event plus the time for the particular activity IJ. Then total float. The next term is total float. The total float of an activity IJ is given by TFIJ equal to LSIJ minus ESI. The activity with zero float, total float, are known as critical activities. So in the CPM calculation, CPM network calculation, the total float plays a significant role in the calculation. So total float, when the total float equal to zero, it is known as the critical activity. The total float represents the time by which the activity can be delayed without affecting the project completion time. So in the earlier PERT network, all the computations are based on the critical event. So here we calculate everything based on the activity. And the free float is of an activity IJ is calculated by FFIJ equal to ESJ minus ECIJ, which is also equal to total float minus head event slack. So slack also we calculated earlier in the PERT computation. So we have to calculate the slack here and subtracting from the total float of the head event slack, that is called as free float. The free float is that portion of the total float within which an activity can be manipulated without affecting the floats of the subsequent activities. So independent float. Independent float of an activity IJ is given by IFIJ equal to ESJ minus LCI plus minus TEIJ, which is equal to free float minus tail event slack. Independent float is that portion of the total float within which the activity can be delayed without affecting the float of the preceding activity. So in the PERT network, we have to calculate the various parameters and based on the total float will identify the critical path or critical activity and the critical path of the network. We take an example. Example number 9. A maintenance activity consists of the following jobs. Draw the network and calculate the total float and free float for each activity. The job and the duration in days. The jobs are 1 to 2 which consumes 3 days, 2 to 3 which consumes 4 days, 3 to 4, 4 days, 3 to 7, 4 days, 4 to 5, 2 days, 4 to 7, 2 days, 5 to 6, 3 days, and 6 to 7, 2 days. The project work with the TE and TL value, slack value of different events are shown below. So this is the network. So 1 to 2, 3 days, 2 to 4, 4 days, 3 to 4, 4 days, and 3 to 7, 4 days, 4 to 5, 2 days, 4 to 7, 2 days, 5 to 6, 3 days, and 6 to 7, 2 days. So the values are given. So the event number is given at the top of the circle, and the left side is TE value, expected time, earliest expected time, and right side bottom is the TL value, the usual notations what we used earlier. Now we calculate the value. So the values are shown here in the network. We'll calculate the value. So the TE1 for the initial event, we fix the TE1 equal to 0. For the second event, there is only one incoming arrow, TE2 equal to TE1 plus TE12, which is 0 plus 3 equal to 3 days. And event 3, there is only one incoming arrow. So TE3 equal to TE2 plus TE23 equal to 3 plus 4 equal to 7. For the fourth event, there is only one incoming arrow. So TE4 equal to TE3 plus TE34 equal to 7 plus 4 equal to 11. TE5, event number 5, there is only one incoming arrow. So TE4 plus TE45 equal to 11 plus 2 equal to 13 days. And TE6, there is only one incoming arrow. So TE5 minus TE56 equal to 13 plus 3 equal to 16 days. And TE7, there are 3 incoming arrow. So maximum of TE3 plus TE37, 7 plus 4 equal to 11. TE4 plus TE47, 11 plus 2 equal to 13. And TE6 plus TE67, 16 plus 2 equal to 18. So the maximum value is 18. So 18 is the earliest expected time of the event 7. Similarly, we use the backward pass computation to calculate the latest allowable occurrence time of the network. The latest allowable occurrence time are given in the bottom right of the event. We take the calculation. TL7 equal to TE7 equal to 18, because the time is not given in the problem. We make TL7 equal to TE7. TL6, for the sixth event, there is only one outgoing arrow. TL6 equal to TL7 minus TE67, which is 18 minus 2 equal to 16 days. TL5, there is only one outgoing arrow. So TE6 minus TE67 equal to 16 minus 3 equal to 13 days. TL4, there are two outgoing arrows. So the minimum of TL7 minus TE47 equal to 18 minus 2, 16. And the TL5 minus TE45, 13 minus 2, 11. The minimum value is 11. So 11 is the TL value for the fourth event. And the TL3, again there are two outgoing arrows. So the minimum of TL7 minus TE37, which is 18 minus 4 equal to 14. And the TL4 minus TE34 equal to 11 minus 4 equal to 7. So the minimum value is 7. So the TL value is 7 here. And the TL2, there is only one outgoing arrow. So TL3 minus TE23 equal to 7 minus 4 equal to 3. And the TL1, there is only one outgoing arrow. So TL1 equal to TL2 minus TE12 equal to 3 minus 3 equal to 0. Then we calculate the slack value of all the events. Slack value is TL minus TE. 0 minus 0 equal to 0. 3 minus 3 equal to 0. 7 minus 7 equal to 0. 11 minus 11 equal to 0. 13 minus 13 equal to 0. 16 minus 16 equal to 0. And 18 minus 18 equal to 0. So for all the events, the slack value equal to 0. Now we go for the PERT computation to calculate the total float and free float calculation of the PERT project network. So the jobs are given in the first column. The activity times are given in the second column. So 3, 4, 4, 7, 4, 2, 2, 3, 2. And the ESI, which is equal to TEI. So from the network, we take the value 0, 3, 7, 7, 11, 11, 13 and 16. LCJ, which is equal to TLJ. So again, we take from the network value 3, 7, 11, 18, 13, 18, 16 and 18. And the LSIJ equal to LCJ minus TEIJ. So this LCJ equal to TLJ. So 3. So the third column minus the first column. So 3 minus 3 equal to 0. 7 minus 4 equal to 3. 11 minus 4 equal to 7. 18 minus 4 equal to 14. 13 minus 2 equal to 11. 18 minus 2 equal to 16. 16 minus 3 equal to 13. And 18 minus 2 equal to 16. Then ECIJ equal to ESI plus TEIJ. So ESI is the second column plus the third column plus the second column. 0 plus 3 equal to 3. 3 plus 4 equal to 7. 7 plus 4 equal to 11, 7 plus 4 equal to 11, 11 plus 2 equal to 13, 11 plus 2 equal to 13, 13 plus 3 equal to 16, and 16 plus 2 equal to 18. Then we calculate the total float of the activity ij, which is LSij minus ESI. LSij is the fifth column and ESI is the third column. So 0 minus 0 equal to 0, 3 minus 3 equal to 0, 7 minus 7 equal to 0, 14 minus 7 equal to 7, 11 minus 11 equal to 0, 16 minus 11 equal to 5, 13 minus 13 equal to 0, and 16 minus 16 equal to 0. So the total float is 0 for the activity 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, and 6, 7. So these are all the critical activities. And the free float, which is equal to total float minus head event slack. So the head event slack for all the events, the slack equal to 0. If you look at the network, for all the events, the slack equal to 0. So we can take total float equal to free float. So total float is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 7, 7, 0, 0, 5, 5, 0, 0, and 0, 0. So because the float, head event slack of all the activity, all the events are 0. So here in this example, the total float is equal to the free float. Now the critical path of the network is 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, and 6, 7, which is marked as a dark line here. 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6, 7. This is the critical path of the network. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find the operation research book. You can refer to the book for additional information on the PERT CPM. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel. Use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video lecture on the CPM calculation. Until then, bye-bye.